If people of Reddit, what is your go-to generic fake explanation for why a computer was not working if you don't feel like the end user wouldn't understand the actual explanation? Rather than a lengthy explanation, haha yeah, it's like they have a mind of their own. You're just not scary enough. I've lost count of how many systems I've fixed where the issues involved resolved themselves just because I sat down at the keyboard. I used to work in Microsoft Premier support with a guy called Mike. He was very good, and could tell pretty quick when a reinstall of the OS was a faster and cleaner solution to the problem than hours of troubleshooting, and would pitch it with something deep down in the operating system is broken, and we can't fix it. He was so good on the phone, it almost always worked. Just needed to update Adobe Reader. I simplify, but I don't lie. I end up using a lot of telephone analogies because people think they understand telephone systems. My best fake explanation is that we have the technician aura that magically fixes things as soon as we arrive. That's obviously why it's working now but wasn't before. My real go-to explanation was, do you wanna know? Cause I'll explain it if you do, or, since I was help desk for a while, I don't know why it did that, but I made it so it doesn't do that anymore. We're good here. Sometimes computers do these things, edit, wow. My very first gold awarded for giving the laziest possible explanation to customers, thanks. Reason behind it is pretty technical and I don't want to put you to sleep, but I will explain it if you really want me to. Customer holds hands up in front them and backs away from me, no. That's okay, thanks. I'm good. Former cable customer care rep, people never actually check if a HDMI cord is loose, they either just glance at it or lie entirely. Instead of asking if something is loose, I tell them we need discharge any buildup static and we have to unplug the cable and plug it back in, voila. All computers have errors in their programming, the longer they run, those errors accumulate. Generally, restarting the computer will clear the errors and it'll begin running fine again. It was an issue in our systems that our information security policy prohibits me from disclosing the nature of. The problem appears to be somewhere between the monitor and the chair. I love when this happens. My go-to statement is, computers are weird sometimes, they work then they don't, just remember they're a bunch of rocks and metal we've somehow tricked into thinking. The capacitors are overcharged so you have to shut it down for 30 seconds to let them discharge. That makes sure they actually do reboot. My typical answer is, I wish I was smart enough to tell you, that way I don't sound like a know-it-all and chance making them feel ignorant. Every once in a while, Windows just gets settings confused. It's a Windows thing, so don't worry about it. While technically true, it's the most bullgarbage excuse that is always my go-to for when I can't figure out what the fluff just happened but a restart fixes it. This is slightly off topic, but the most insane one I've ever seen was from the CTO of a small company in downtown Denver. He had a particularly incompetent employee who was unqualified and never got any work done. The CTO explained, when questioned about it in a meeting with the president of the company, that the reason said employee's work was not completed was because their workstation was in a direct line of sight to a microwave tower on a nearby telecom company building, and the microwave rays were corrupting their CPU. To this day, I'm still not sure whether the CTO was that dumb, or just covering for their awful employee. I try not to lie because as soon as someone figures out I lied, it breaks the trust of me actually fixing their computer. I am honest and tell them what I believe the problem is and what I tried. If they don't understand, that is fine. But it was broken. If they want more, I'll tell them what was wrong in gory detail until they ask me to stop. Complex problem to rough analogy to question users' understanding, if inadequate, to reduce analogy to simpler terms or modify to use terms the user is familiar with. Star Trek got this garbage down decades ago, like putting too much air in a balloon. Pebcac. Driver conflict, need to update the DLL library and run msconfig, just take a sec. The midichlorians overloaded the mainframe and I had to force a reboot resulting in invalid memory errors. With the Plumbus reset, the artificial intelligence should take over and complete the imaging process. Not an it person but I was helping my grandma with her computer and all I did was clear the what looked like pounds of dust off of it and restarted it and it ran a lot faster. But I just said that she had too many things plugged into the computer. Picnic error, problem in chair not in computer. Your Wi-Fis are near depleted. I never use fake explanations. You might get someone that will call you out on it. Make it simple and avoid lots of jargon and most people will be happy with the explanation. What really sucks is using a fake explanation and getting called out for it. If computers acted the way they should, I would be out of a job. It was not up to date, or it was because of an update. Tell the truth. I have no idea why it was down, but it works now. Layer 8 issue. isnt error. Computers can be weird sometimes. It's a Microsoft bug. It's an isnt issue. isnt. I did it for 30 years and never had a fake explanation. I told the truth and my users trusted me because of it. I always tell people to unplug the Ethernet cable and switch ends, and then when it works I tell them it was plugged in the wrong way. I do this every time I need them to reseat a cable. I never lie to them, I always try to explain it with a metaphor instead. These people aren't beneath me, unlike a lot of it guys think. The computer is broke because it did exactly what you told it to do. Yeah, it's weird, sometimes the password stuff gets weird and you have to reset it. It was a 3-day weekend and you're an idiot. Uninstall, reinstall, I am not a software engineer ma'am, I don't know why it works, I just know that it does work. It's just a thing that happens, do you know those pains that just come and go seemingly out of nowhere in your body somewhere? It's like that, but in a computer. I don't. I help the person understand what happened. Every time. Any significantly advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic, Arthur C. Clarke. It's having a bad day. If they want more details, they get more details. Having a help desk position for a building full of engineers is priceless. They demand to know in detail what happened exactly once, because most of the time they cause the problem like any other user and refuse to see it until you walk them through it. Then they can't look at me for days. The end user's ability to understand the explanation lies with our ability to explain it. When I was doing technical support, I would explain what I was doing and why and recap at the end of the call. Educating the end user, or at least making the effort to keep them informed of what we're doing, is showing them that you respect them. It creates a good experience for the end user, it makes them far more cooperative, and it makes for an overall less stressful experience, me as well as them. It's our responsibility to speak to the level that the end user is at rather than condescending to them. Just tell them it's an isnt error. I explain exactly what the issue was and, if possible, how to avoid it. It doesn't matter so much to me that they understood all that. The only thing that matters is that they knew I did something, and I have the solution that works well in my performance review. Server down. Feel like the end user wouldn't understand equals you don't understand well enough to explain it simply. It's not nuclear physics, I've been doing this a long time, and if I can't explain it clearly, then I don't know what did it. You explain it like they are 5 years old, why lie? I'm not an IT person, but I'm generally the go-to for my family and friends with tech issues, since I have a basic understanding of how stuff works. Often I'm just like, I reset the insert setting component here, and it shouldn't do that anymore, even if that's far from the case. It doesn't like you. When I worked at my friend's computer repair shop, people would come in all the time and everything would be working fine. We can't replicate the issue at the counter. So I'd tell them either that it was the magic countertop that fixed it, or that their computer just wanted to go for a ride, and #X200B, 99% of the time they just needed to restart their computer, but every once in a while it'd be their home internet connection. Not an actual it, but my whole fluffing family seems to think I am. Whenever I restart the router, whenever I fix their stuff, I just say that some of their drivers updated but others were outdated, so they didn't detect each other. And then I make some comparison to something they understand. I usually say to my dad, your computer is trying to use a Phillips head screwdriver on a flat head screw. To my brother I say, your computer is trying to put a rifle mag into a pistol. To my dogs I say, y'all are good boys. Russian hackers. Not me personally, but in my experience, every time a vendor can't figure out an issue, they just scream firewall and hang up the phone. Looks like Outlook is ready for a vacation. I'll force it to work. I try to be honest without accusing the user of malice or incompetence, especially after I accidentally brought down the fax server for about 20 minutes through a simple mistake, but I am lucky the company I work for has chill employees. It makes being on the phones nicer when you can joke with everyone. Solar flare, or sometimes I'll just say it's a bug that the developing company knows about, but hasn't released a patch yet. 36 year at tech here. My most common explanations, picnic error, explained elsewhere in this thread, isnt error, also explained elsewhere, short in the system between the keyboard and the seat computers break just like refrigerators and cars. My favorite, PFM, pure effin' magic, I frequently say, when computers are working, they are great. When they are not, they are profitable. I do my best to translate geek speak into English. When someone says they are not good with computers, I ask them, do you know what we call people like you? They usually look at me sheepishly, expecting some demeaning retort. I respond with, good customers. I fully understand that it is these people who provided me a very comfortable living for 36 years now.